Hey, Jedovi 3D fam. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're taking the Anycubic Kobra Max to the next level with some upgrades. We're talking a new motherboard, a fancy extruder, an amazing hotend nozzle, Klipper firmware, and even a BLTouch. Let's dive in and take a look at this 3D printing beast. First up, we're swapping the original motherboard for the bigtreetech SKR Mini E3 V3. I use Klipper as the firmware with the Raspberry Pi. I'll leave a link in the description for the bigtreetech's GitHub files for this firmware. I hit a snag with the hotend PCB wires. The stock printer cable just wouldn't play nice, so I wired it directly to the motherboard. A bit of a puzzle, but totally worth it. If you're snazzy with a multimeter, you'll probably be able to figure it out. But here's what I do know, and it's probably the most difficult part to figure out, and that's how to wire the BLTouch. If you turn over the original Tri-Gorilla board, the hotend PCB is connected to the E connection. My guess is the original plan was to go for a direct extruder because the E obviously stands for extruder, and there are pins for a stepper motor. Nevertheless, you will have to update your hotend PCB to a stealth burner by Maker Panda. The wire connections for the BLTouch goes as follows. Probe or signal, ground, servo, 5 volts power, and ground. The corresponding wires from the original hotend ribbon are SCL for the probe or signal, of course ground for ground, there are 2 wires in this port, SDA for the servo, 5 volts, and the second wire out of the ground port for the ground. I didn't properly wire the TO to regulate my hotend temp, so I failed. Now the end stops. They were being a little tricky, always reading that they were triggered. So I dove into the config file and added an explanation point before the pinout name. It's like telling the printer, hey, think opposite. And voila, it worked. The Y-axis motor on this printer is beefy because it moves a big build plate with 2 belts. I had to boost the run current to 1.5 or it just couldn't handle the bed moving back and forth. Remember, the X and Z axis needs a tweak in the current too. Raise their run current to 1. Now for the cool part, converting from a bolt-in to a direct extruder. I covered this install with Troy's design from printables.com in a previous video. I'll leave a link to that video in the description. I installed the Sherpa Mini Extruder on the Kobra Max. I couldn't use Troy's design for this, so I used Media Man's 3D's Hero Me Gen 7 on printables.com, which I tweaked a bit, but I'll leave a link in the description for these original awesome hotend designs. As far as the extruder, trust me, the Sherpa Mini is a game changer. And we can't forget the E3D Revo 6 hotend nozzle. Combined with the antclab's BLTouch for perfect leveling, our Kobra Max is not just a printer anymore, it's a 3D printing monster. The original leveling snags are one of the main reasons I modded this printer. We now have a more efficient bed mesh tool for more accurate prints and first layers. Last but not least, I mentioned we installed Klipper. If you've been 3D printing for years or just getting started, I'm sure you've already heard about this firmware. It allows you to really take control of the functionality of your 3D printer. One of the latest and most useful features it has is adaptive bed mesh leveling. This allows your printer's bed mesh leveling system to just focus on the area that's about to be printed on, which is perfect for the printer's gigantic bed. I'll create a video specifically focusing on this feature in the future. Yeah, these upgrades add up, but for the speed and efficiency, absolutely worth it. Your Anycubic Kobra Max will thank you, creating some of the most large and beautiful prints you've ever seen on this printer. Got any upgrades on this printer you're curious about? Drop a comment below. I'll create a video specifically showing the step-by-step process of what I did to help make your printer the best it can be. That's what I'm here for.
We will see about that.
I'm super excited about what Jedovi has next up. I'll be building an Ender NG live on this channel. You'll be with me every step of the way. I won't touch the build unless we're live on YouTube. You won't want to miss it. So subscribe and hit that notification bell to catch all of the action.
Sounds interesting.
That's it for today's mega upgrade journey. Thanks for watching. Happy printing, people. I'll see you in the next video.